Do you want to make fancy potatoes? Make smashed potatoes. Not mashed, smashed. These are going to be your favorite new recipe, and I'm going to show you how easy they are to make. Hey everyone, it's Yumna, aka Feel Good Foodie, and every time I make these smashed potatoes at dinner, I get so many remarks about how crispy they are, how delicious they are, and just how fun they are. They're seriously the best side dish for holidays, celebrations, and even weeknight meals. They are crazy crispy on the outside, fabulously fluffy on the inside, and all around just so tasty. So if you're looking for a new way to serve up potatoes, you have to give these a try. Let's get started. We're gonna start by parboiling the potatoes. So parboiling just means cooking them halfway. So we want them to be fork tender, but not too soft. And I like to add a heavy pinch or more of salt to the water because that's really going to penetrate into the potatoes and really flavor them. So we'll go ahead and add the potatoes to the boiling water. And I'm using yellow baby potatoes. You want them to be kind of small, like this size, because it really helps to just make them more crispy all around. It's harder to do this with russet potatoes or big red potatoes. But if you are working with those, you can just cut them in half or in quarter. But this is what we're looking for. And after about 15 or 20 minutes, the potatoes should be nice and tender. You can do a quick check with a knife or a fork, and that's perfect. That's just what we're looking for. And now you can set them aside on a baking dish, and we're ready to move on with the recipe. I'm also using some fresh rosemary. Sometimes this can burn a little bit in the oven, but I think it gives it so much good flavor, and I like to still throw it on there. You can use just dried rosemary or dill or oregano or any other kind of seasoning you want. So I'm gonna go ahead and chop this up. Oh, it smells so good, and I swear it makes all the difference in this recipe. This time of preparing the seasoning also helps the potatoes cool down just a little bit so that we can handle them without burning ourselves. And I feel that it kind of allows them to also air steam in the pan, which also makes them more crispy in the end. All right, now it's time to grab those potatoes and then arrange them on the baking dish. You want to keep them kind of separated so that they don't steam too much in the oven, but get nice and crispy. So I like doing 12 on a baking sheet, and I think that's perfect. For the fun part now, the smash part. You can either smash them using a potato masher or the flat end of a cup. So we're gonna use both of them, and I'll show you guys what it looks like. And don't worry if it's not perfect. Actually, when it's messy and there's lots of ridges, it makes them more crispy. So let's get started. I'll show you what this looks like. And don't worry if they're not perfect. Sometimes they do get stuck to the potato masher. Sometimes they kind of fall apart. That's the beauty of this recipe. It's okay what they look like. It's all about the taste, and they're gonna get nice and crispy, and that's all we care about. Let me show you what it looks like using the bottom of a cup. I think it's actually a little bit easier and neater to use the bottom of a cup. Kind of stays together a little bit more than using a potato masher. All right, time to flavor these with some salt, some pepper, some rosemary, and lots of olive oil. I like to use about a fourth of a cup of olive oil, but you can also just eyeball it and drizzle them on. And this is also what helps them get really crispy in the oven. And you can also add some garlic. You can use dried garlic or you can use fresh garlic. I'm team fresh garlic whenever possible. I think it adds such good flavor. Just kind of massage it in there with your hands. And now for the cheese factor, add a little bit of grated Parmesan cheese on top. This part is optional, but once you taste them, you'll see it's not so optional. And now we're going to bake these smashed potatoes in the oven at 425 for 15 minutes. Remove them, flip them, and then return them back in the oven until they're nice and crispy. Now when you're flipping them, feel free to add more salt, more pepper, more Parmesan cheese, and even a little drizzle of more olive oil. And here's the final product. Look how good these look, you guys. They are so nice and crisp. Also, they make like actually really good finger food. So you can just dip these in some ketchup, you can dip them with ranch, or just on their own. So I'm gonna hand this over to Video Matt. Let's see what he thinks. many thumbs up. He likes the recipe. So glad he likes it. And I'm gonna go ahead and taste one as well. And I want you guys just to hear like the nice crispness of the potatoes. It's the best when you get those crispy bits. So good. I hope you guys love these as much as we do. Be sure to check out the full recipe on my website and let me know if you try them.